This video is about setting up an Illustrator document to fit a media kit, size requirements. So, and here are the size requirements for the media kit. You can see we're actually going to use the size per full page slash cover. So in Illustrator, we're going to make a new file. Where it says width and height, we are going to put in the trim size. That's 8 inches. So let's change our unit of measure to match what's being asked for. 8 inches. Tab down. 10 7/8. So that's 10. And 7/8 is 0.875. 10.875. And now we're going to add the bleed. The bleed is determined by the difference between the bleed size and the trim size. So you can see that we have a 1/4 inch difference here between the trim. You see the 8 here for trim, and for bleed it says 8 1/4. That means that there's 1/8 inch on each side of the paper, and so that's 0.125. So where it says bleed, I'm going to type in 0.125. That's 1/8 inch. Notice that populates all the way across the bottom left and right. If you want to be sure that it's the same all the way around, you can take the other figure and you can see that we have for trim 10 7/8, and for bleed we have 11 1/8. And if you subtract 10 7/8 from 11 1/8, then you also wind up with a 1/4 inch, which divided by 2, because the paper has a left side and a right side, also has a top and a bottom, that's also 0.125. So that's pretty much it for that part of it. You click OK, and we have our document. Now we have another thing that we need to add, and that is the live area. Now here, the red line here indicates the bleed size. So when you design, you're going to design, if you have color that goes to the edge of your paper, it needs to go from red line all the way over to the red line. The part in between your document here, edge, and the red line is the area that's going to be trimmed away. So this area in between the red line and the edge of the artboard is going to be trimmed away after the printing process. But we need to add our live area now. Our live area is 7.5 by 10 3/8. So that's 7.5. I'm going to get my box here, and don't really, this is going to be a guide, and so the stroke doesn't even really matter, but it'll help us see it for now. I'm going to double click here, and again, that live area size is 7.5, so that's 7.5. Tab to the next field. The other figure is 10 3/8. So that's 10.375. 3/8 is 0.375. Click OK. Now we have the right size live area, but it's not in position. So the next thing we need to do is to align it. So we're going to go to Window Align. Actually, it's already showing. If you have your showing already, go to it. If you don't, go to the Window menu and select it. From the pop-up here, we need to choose Show Options, because this is where we're going to align it to the artboard. And where it says Align Objects, I'm going to click here in the middle where it says Horizontal Align Center. I'm going to come over here to the right, to the middle of this group, and choose Vertical Align Center. And that puts our live area in to our document, but we're not through yet, because this would actually print. See, it has a stroke. We want this just to be a guide, so we're going to go View, Guides, Make Guides. And now that the guide's been made, I'm going to go to the layers here, and I'm going to lock it so that I can't move it. And I will create all my artwork on layers above this. So live area means that any of your critical information has to go inside this inner blue line. That I'm talking about logos, I'm talking about URLs, you know, web addresses. Anything that's important needs to go within this line, because the thing is that when this document is printed and trimmed, the trim may fall outside of our artboard area, in which case you would still have color there, so it wouldn't show a white sliver of paper. If the trim error is to the inside, then that means that all your important information is protected because it's far away enough from the trim edge. So all of your design goes inside of the live area. And that's it.